the receiver is the one that gives the verbal cue to when the switch will happen. Alright? So when he runs across, without defenders, he just wants to do that. They keep on going diagonally out that way, and then the cue space totally.
Straighten up.
Right? So you need to basically teach them once again to straighten up. Right? On a higher level, it depends on what they see on the defensive line. Alright? For this level, just teach them to come in at an angle and then straighten up. Alright? Okay, so once you add defenders, the ball can start from either side. These still same thing, because there's a lot of distance here. All you want to do is basically run up first, block bend in, come in. Yep. Now. Okay. On the outside, encourage them to score as well. Okay, now, there's something called the B or the hack switch. Now this is not something that you want to teach, in my opinion, something that you want to teach the kids, right? Because it's very hard for them to basically get a switch. It's a very hard skill to learn, right? From my experience, right? So, but it's a good thing to know, because as you build up into under 16s, under 18s, you basically can introduce a switch. Right? The switch is basically the change of direction or the change of the direction of the play, right? For the game. Alright, now this is very different from the union way of switching. Now the union way of switching, when Lee goes in, I go really close in here, because why, I can basically flash bend doing that. Alright, so there's no reason why I should basically push myself wider. Now for a touch switch, for the hard switch, what you want to do is avoid getting touched. Okay, because all it takes is a swipe on your sleeve and you have to stop the play. Right? So what you want to do is continue the play without getting touched. Right? So a grip that I usually like to do is, alright, let's push back a bit. Okay? Bend over back as well. Right? So if the ball starts from me, for example, alright? What I want to do is basically tell Lee, you need to grab bend across this way, or push bend, or make him follow you across this way. Alright? So that I can get across to the other way. Now, key things to remember here, number one, yes, straighten up, but if the distance between you and the defender is very close, there's no point straightening up as well, just go across and pull the defender across. Alright, so as you're doing that, bend follows. Now, my job here is to lock that defender first, make him stay. Alright, so when BT stays in there, I know that he's in there. Now, when bend comes across, he keeps going, and now this is when I... Notice that the distance between the passer and the receiver is rather wide. Hey, anybody can say why?
Well, this needs to be a pop, not a pass. It's not a pass, it's a pop.
So the union, right,
is a pop. It'll just double tap.
Yeah, that's it. Now, what happens when you pop the ball? It means I have to get closer. When I get closer, Ben can reach, because this reach is really close. Even if Ben is across this way, that's a late switch, okay? And I touch the ball near this pitch is here. Now compare this with, you catch the ball, Ben is there, okay? Same thing, same lines of run, Ben gets high.